Today on Keep Classical Weird, a start of yet another series of episodes designed to build your library with interesting, arcane, and sometimes downright wacky pieces to listen to. Stay tuned! Welcome, friends, to episode 32 of Keep Classical Weird. I am your host, Casey Bozell, and today is the first in a series of episodes designed to throw a new classical piece of music into the mix of what you listen to. I'm calling it Build Your Library, and I'll be playing you little excerpts of the piece sprinkled throughout the episode, as well as background on the piece and composer. I should note that while these are public domain pieces, finding public domain performances of little-known classical works is difficult, so I'll be trying to recreate them using the instruments I know how to play. So, potentially, you're in for two wild rides. Today's selection is not that much of a stretch for a string player, however, as we'll be talking about Battalia by Heinrich Bieber. Heinrich Ignaz Franz Bieber was born in August of 1644 in the small Bohemian town of Wartenberg, in an area now known as the Czech Republic. He moved to Salzburg in early adulthood, and it was there that he did the majority of his composing and publishing. Now, his lifespan puts him on the border of a late Renaissance, early Baroque time period, and things like string pedagogy weren't completely figured out yet. The violin wasn't even a century old by the time he was born. But Bieber was thrilled enough by the possibilities of the instrument, and he wrote all kinds of techniques for string instruments that effectively disappeared from the repertoire for years. In fact, many of the things we'll discuss in this particular piece don't pop up again until the Romantic era of string repertoire. This either makes him an outlier or an innovator, and either way, he's pretty fascinating. Battalia was composed in 1673, and while Bieber didn't dedicate the meaning of it to any war specifically, it's been thought that it was a musical response to the Thirty Years' War, which had ended in 1648. It took the lives of millions of Europeans, and Bieber would have certainly seen the fallout in his native land. Composed for string orchestra and continuo, which is usually played as a combination of harpsichord and bass instrument, Battalia has 8 short movements. They all serve as little snapshots of different ideas and images of war. The first, Presto 1, sounds like a call to battle, and here Bieber employs a technique called colegno, which requires the string players to turn their bow around and hit the string with the wood of the bow instead of the hair. Now, at first, that might sound like a very bad idea that damages the instrument, but it's actually a fairly gentle technique, and the wood of the bow is already pretty strong. The second movement is my favorite, if I may editorialize here. The description of this movement translates to the lusty society of common humor, in which soldiers from several different nations gather together and very drunkenly sing the songs of their people, all at the same time. The result is a hilarious mash of notes that sounds like the orchestra is completely lost, even though they're not. Presto 2 comes next, and it is a mere 7 measures played 2 times in a row. It's peppy and singable, and honestly, Bieber might have just put it in at this point to reset the audience's ear. Following this is the 4th movement, Der Marsch, or The March. It's scored for either bass or cello and solo violin, and it's supposed to imitate the military band leading the way to the battlefield. The violin is high and fast and virtuosic, most likely representing a fife, and the bass is meant to imitate a snare drum. Now, how does one take a string instrument and even get close to the timbre of a drum? I'll tell you how, by placing a piece of paper under the strings to evoke the rattle of the snares. I'm going to demonstrate it here on a viola, but the effect gets deeper and even more realistic when the instrument is bigger. A sprightly sounding Presto 3 comes next, reminding everyone that we're hyping up the troops for the big face-off just around the corner. But before we get there, we arrive at a beautiful aria. What's this one representing? Is this a moment of repose? Perhaps the soldiers get a minute to think about their loved ones at home. Finally, after the aria, the movement entitled The Battle. There's a technique here that, again, you don't see much of in any other early music, and it doesn't pop up again until much later in music history. It's what currently is known as Bartok pizzicato, or snap pizzicato, and that's where the string players pluck their strings so hard that they rebound it enough to slap it on the fingerboard, so you're hearing both a pitch and a percussive sound. Seem to paint war in kind of a glorious light. We've been in a major key the whole time. Most movements have been pretty fast and even some downright joyous. So one might expect a movement symbolizing victory at the end of this work. Bieber goes in a very different direction and instead ends the piece with a lament. When you're working on building a classical library, there are some really excellent resources out there. YouTube has a lot of wonderful recordings, and it's a great way to find groups that you like. If you search for Battalia, for instance, and find a group that you really seem to enjoy, you might try subscribing to their channel, or even just browsing the rest of their videos to see what they have to offer. You may have local groups that specialize in these kinds of performances. We're lucky here, for example, to have the Portland Baroque Orchestra, which programs fantastic early works all the time. And of course, if you're not sure where exactly to start, you can always email me at keepclassicalweird@gmail.com. I really love hearing from you. And that's our show for today. Our theme music is by not dead composer Thomas Barber. Check out his stuff at thomasbarber.com. Web development support is provided by Tina at citybeautifuldesign.com. Keep Classical Weird is created and edited by me, Casey Bozell. Find us on Facebook, Instagram, and Patreon. Thank you so much for listening, everyone. Stay safe and stay weird.